Hi, all folks. This is Max from GalaxyS2Root.com. So the official ICS has been out for the AT&T Galaxy S2. So here's a tutorial for those of you on custom ROMs. You don't have to update to Gingerbread. You can update straight to the ICS version if you want to. To do this, make sure you have micro USB connected to your computer. Actually, that's my AC charger. Connect it to your computer and hold down volume up, volume down, and the power button until your phone resets. Alright. And there you go. And keep holding it down and hit volume up. And then let's go to our computer. Next, you'll need to download GalaxyS2Root.com/i77_UCLE5. If you unzip it, you'll find this file called blah 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 home.tar.md5, alright? Leave that alone. And also go download Odin and unzip it. You'll get an Odin folder. Go ahead and run Odin. And you'll get this familiar Odin thingy here. Make sure you get the COM sign here. The number doesn't matter. And also you can close keys. Anything that says keys, you can end process. Sometimes that interferes with the process. And also, don't use a USB hub. Connect your phone directly to your computer. Otherwise, you get a lot of fails. You can always redo it. If it fails in the middle, you can always try it again. Not that big of a deal. But it should work the first time if you have all those things done. And if you don't get the yellow sign, then you might not have the drivers installed. Go ahead and install Samsung Keys, and also unplug and plug your phone back in. So once you've got all this set, ready to go, hit PDA, and go find the file, the GalaxyS2Root.com, blah blah, there. And inside you'll find the blah blah.tar.md5. Open, and hit start, and this will pretty much unroot your phone back to or up to the ICS official update from yesterday. And also, this will get you to the factory ROM. So if you want root, I'll have another file that you can install in Clockwork Mod Recovery, so you don't actually have to use unroot and then root it again. Although I'll have a root method again for the ICS, so you know, you'll have a bunch of ways to update to the stock ICS. That's why when you asked me, if you install custom ROMs, can you update it, using keys? No, but you can do this to get the ICS, or there should be a rooted stock ROM you can install in Clockwork Mod Recovery, which I'll also have instructions on. If you want to do that, if you don't want to root your phone again, then you can wait for that. For those of you who, you know, want this, then you can go do this. Anyway, I'll be back when this is done. It is almost done. The factory FS is the factory stock image, the ROM. Now it's flashing the kernel. It's almost done here, and it should reboot, and you're all good to go. And I'll change the camera angle and also show you how to do a factory reset. Sometimes, you know, you might have to do that if you're coming from a custom ROM. So it says reset, and my phone looks like that. All right, and I'll switch my camera angle and show you the new stock ROM. And actually, it's going through the Android stock recovery. It's gonna do its thing and reboot one more time, which is not a big deal. So let me switch the camera angle now. After you see the Samsung logo, there, Hi, folks. It actually booted up instantly. It took like 5 seconds, literally. I've got settings about phone. Wow, it is really fast. UCLE5, you can see there, the kernel UCLE5. So this is completely stock. I'm very impressed. It is very, very fast. Love this. If you have any problems, like you get a lot of force closes, here's how to do factory reset, okay? Any problems, you might want to do a factory reset if you're coming from a custom ROM. Make sure your micro USB is plugged off there. And let me turn all the lights here. And hold down volume up, volume down, and the power button until your phone resets into start recovery. I know, I've got the half Galaxy S i9100, half AT&T. You can do this if you want to. Here we go. So hold it down until you see the stock ICS recovery. Here you can go to wipe data factory reset, hit the power button, say yes, and boom. This will pretty much put your phone completely back to stock. Reboot it, and you're all good to go pretty much. And I'll be back when this reboots. Alright folks, so when you do a factory reset, it's gonna reset everything, of course, but it will fix all those force closes or any kind of problems you have. If you're coming from a custom ROM, you can also come from a stock ROM, it should be fine. You don't need to probably do a factory reset, but I'll be back when this completely reboots. Hi all folks, so I'm back here with the start. It's been completely back to stock here. Looking pretty good. I will have a I'll have another guide on how to do this using Mobile Odin also, for those of you who don't have Windows computer, or also it can get rid of the count, binary count, using the Odin method. The count is still there, but I'll have another method using that. Anyway, thanks you guys for watching this. That's how you unroot your phone back to ICS, or the new ICS here. And if you have a Galaxy S2 AT&T or the i9100 or the T-Mobile, don't forget to sign up for my email list at galaxys2root.com. We update you once a week with ROM of the Week, stuff like this. And also, it's a great way for you to get in contact with me if you mess up your phone via email. And also, if you're on YouTube, please hit that like button for me. It helps me greatly. Share button down here to share this with your friends on Twitter, Facebook, or Google+. And use that subscribe button to share it. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Anyway, stay high on Android, folks. I've got a ton of stuff coming this week, and you can check out all my, all my rants over at this channel or my High on Android channel. And see y'all later. Have a great day.